Hello children, welcome back to your PS class. In the previous session, we discussed about some topics of this coal and petroleum chapter, that is fifth chapter in your textbook. And what are the topics, which topics we discussed? Let us recall the topic names. Those are what is meant by a resource and types of resources. Exhaustible and inexhaustible natural resources, fossil fuels, and what is meant by a fuel, its types, coal, what are the characteristics of coal, uses, and also formation of coal, constituents of coal, their characteristics and uses. And after that, petroleum, its characteristics. These all topics we discussed in the previous session, and now I'm going to explain you the remaining topics of this chapter. Explain you about the formation of petroleum. So just like coal, petroleum was also formed from the obtained from the ground, but only difference between the formation of petroleum and coal is, in the case of coal, coal was formed from dead vegetation, that is dead plants. Coming to the petroleum, it was formed from dead sea organisms. Okay, and the remaining process is same. Anyhow, I'm going to explain you about the formation of petroleum. See, some thousands of or millions of years ago, the sea organisms, whichever lived in sea, when they died, they got settled at the seabed, and as time passes by, they were covered by different layers of soil and sand, and finally they were compressed into the deeper and deeper layers of the earth. So already we discussed that as we go into the deeper layers of the earth, there three conditions will be observed. What are those? Because of the pressure of the layers which are present on the on these dead organisms, they may be subjected to high pressure. That means they may be compressed. And the other thing is, high temperature is also present, and absence of air is also seen. Under these conditions, that is in the presence of high temperature and high pressure, and in the absence of air, or these dead organisms, dead sea organisms, whichever got buried, they had slowly converted into petroleum. Okay, so in this way petroleum was formed. The substance. Petroleum is a dark oily substance. Okay. And it is a crude product. That means it is a mixture of different useful substances. Okay. And we can use them by separating from this mixture. So this process of separation of constituents of petroleum is called refining, and this refining is done at separate places which are called refineries. Okay, and children, before these were sent to the refineries, how the petroleum will be extracted, I'm going to give you with a simple diagram which I had given in your textbook. This is reservoir rock, and up to some extent water will be present, and above that oil is present, and above that gas is present, and over that impervious rock is present. Okay, so here this oil is nothing but petroleum, whereas this gas is nothing but natural gas. Okay, about natural gas also we are going to discuss in this chapter, but this is the next topic. Now we are discussing about the petroleum, but along with petroleum only a gas will be formed, that is nothing but natural gas. So both are extracted simultaneously, but by digging two different wells. Okay. So through these pipes, through these wells, this gas and petroleum will be extracted. But here you may get a doubt. These are present near side by side, but why don't they mix? Will they mix? No, they don't mix with water. See, this oil don't it doesn't mix with water. Along with that, it doesn't mix with gas also. Similarly, gas also it doesn't mix with oil and water. Why? Because their densities are different. Gas is having some density and oil is having some other density, and these two are lighter than water, and that is why they float on the water and they don't get mixed with water. Okay, so in this way petroleum reserves will be present, and from them by digging wells this petroleum or natural gas will be extracted. And after extracting, because it is a mixture of different useful substances, then we can't use it directly. That is why it is sent to a place where this different constituents of petroleum will be separated, and those places are said to be refineries. That means these are sent to refineries to separate different constituents of petroleum. So this is about the characteristics of petroleum, its formation and now we are going to discuss about different constituents of petroleum. Okay, already we discussed about this. In the previous session, but not in detail, LPG is nothing but liquefied petroleum gas. Petroleum gas is compressed under high pressure so that it may be converted to LPG, that is liquefied petroleum gas. Whenever we compress gas, then we may get liquid form of that gas. Okay, it is used in homes, okay, for cooking, as a cooking fuel. Then next, kerosene. Kerosene lamps and aviation fuel. Okay, and next, petrol, light motor fuel, means some bikes or scooties or cars, in those are said to be light motor vehicles, in those petrol is used. See children, petrol is different from petroleum. Petroleum is mixture of different substances, whereas petrol is one of the constituents of petroleum. Okay, and the next thing is diesel. Diesel is heavy motor fuel. Okay, and next, paraffin wax. Already I said you about this. Paraffin wax is used in Vaseline, or in the preparation of ointments, and also candles. Okay, and next, lubricating oil. See, this lubricating oil is nothing but grease. Okay, is used as lubricants. Okay, so what is the use of a lubricant? It reduces the wear and tear between the machine parts, and also friction between the machine parts. For suppose, let us consider if you are using your bicycle, and sometimes your chain, if you leave the bicycle for some days during rainy season, then what happens? The chain may get rusted and you don't get free movement of the bicycle while you are riding, right? So to prevent that difficulty, some lubricating oil is provided. That is nothing but sometimes we may use coconut oil, or sometimes we can use this grease also, isn't it? So that is nothing but this lubricating oil, not only in cycle, in different machine parts and in different industries, and also in different vehicles, this lubricating oil is being used. So that is the use of it. Have a look at these. And the last constituent of petroleum is bitumen. It is used in making paints and road surfacing. Okay children, so this is about the constituents of petroleum and their uses. Okay, and next we are going to discuss about natural gas. So natural gas, it is used as a starting material. See children, natural gas is used as a starting material in many industries, and this natural gas, it is very important fuel, such that it is easy to transport through pipes. Okay, such pipeline network, that is natural gas pipeline network. In India, it is present in Vadodara, which is located in Gujarat, and along with that, in some places of Delhi, we can find this natural gas pipelines. So what is the use of it? Directly, instead of using these cylinders, we can send it directly to homes. Just as how we are getting this power supply and water pipes, in the similar way, gas pipes will be present, so that they can directly open those pipes and obtain gas, and directly burn that gas for cooking. in homes and also in industries also they can use it directly. Okay, so such pipeline network, that is that to natural gas pipeline network, is present in India at Vadodara, which is present in Gujarat, and also in some places in Delhi. Okay, this natural gas, it is compressed under high pressure as CNG. Already you had learned about CNG in the previous lesson. What is CNG? Compressed natural gas. That means when we compress a gas, then it may be converted to some liquid form, and this natural gas is compressed under high pressure so that it may become compressed natural gas. What is the use of this compressed natural gas? I shall say you now. See, this compressed natural gas, it is a cleaner fuel when compared to the this diesel, petrol. Okay, so because, and also it produces pollution in lesser amounts when compared to the diesel, petrol which we use in vehicles. Okay, so that is the reason why these days this CNG is replacing that petrol and diesel which is used in vehicles. Okay, so this is one great advantage of this CNG, and these are some important points regarding this CNG. Okay, and already I said you how this natural gas is obtained. It is obtained while extra, this is a gas which is formed near petroleum reserves only, and from there only some pipes, that means some wells will be dug out, and this will be extracted along with petroleum. Okay, so this is about natural gas. And the last topic, and one more important point is there. This natural, India has vast reserves of this natural gas in different places. This natural gas reserves are present in Rajasthan, Maharashtra, Tripura, and also in AP, it is present in Krishna Godavari Delta. So, India has vast reserves of this natural gas in these areas. Okay, and now we are going to discuss about the last topic of this chapter, that is how to conserve these natural resources. Already when we were discussing the starting points of this lesson, at that time we discussed that this coal, petroleum and natural gas are said to be fossil fuels, and this fossil fuels come under which type of natural resources? Exhaustible natural resources. Let us recall what is meant by an exhaustible natural resource. Exhaustible natural resources means their reserves are present in limited quantities, and also they may end up if we use those in larger and larger quantities. Okay, so from past few years these natural resources are being used in larger and larger quantities by our ancestors, and also even we are also using those in large quantities. So if we use in such high rate, if we go on using that, then at a within few hundred years all these reserves will be ended up. Okay, so so that our next generations may face severe difficulty. Why? Because they may run out of the energy suddenly. Okay, and it may take millions of years to produce for the formation of these natural resources. Okay, that is coal, petroleum and natural gas. So that is the reason why our government has set up an association, that is nothing but PCRA. PCRA is nothing but, it is located in India. An association has been set, that is Petroleum Conservation Research Association. So this association is providing some guidelines or some advices to the people to save the natural gas and this petroleum and coal reserves. Okay. So what are those? Ensure correct tire pressure for vehicles. Okay. Ensure regular maintenance of the vehicle. Try to use public transport. Okay. And also the other thing is switch off the engine. When you are jammed in traffic or whenever you need to wait for a while, then in such a case you have to switch off the engine. So these points, if at all we follow, it may lead to the conservation of petrol. Okay, not only petrol, all these exhaustible natural resources. Okay. So what are those? Ensure correct tire pressure, ensure regular maintenance of the vehicle, and try to use public transport. Okay, and the next thing is switch off the engine whenever you are jammed in traffic. Okay, so this is about the coal, petroleum and natural gas and their uses, their constituents. Okay, and also how they were formed and how can we conserve these natural resources. So these topics we discussed in this chapter, that is coal and petroleum, which is 5th chapter in your textbook. By this lesson is completed, and I shall explain you the next lesson in the next session.